inflammation is the basis of most long-term conditions of diabetes, but this anti-inflammatory role gives a powerful role of physical activity. Haven't we thought this out? We walk. Full stop. Walking will create all those benefits, the science behind it. Now, when I tell a patient to go and walk, they look at me and think I'm a bad doctor. Because their granny, or their sister, or their mate in the cafe can tell them to walk. But why, after 7 years training, do I come up and all I give them is something to walk? They want a drug, they want an operation, they want something which can correct the problem, they want something scientific, they want something more technological. Walking is too easy. And yet in England, there are 5.4 million adults who, if they walked 3 miles an hour, would actually find it a vigorous activity. In other words, vigorous activity, they are so out of breath that they cannot hold a conversation without breaking it off their sentences. At 3 miles an hour, I should have done this in kilometres an hour, apologies, but you can work it out, I'm sure. It's about 5 kilometres an hour. It really is very, very, very slow, and these people are very unfit. In Australia, they did a study, and they looked to find out what was the best speed to walk. In the study, they found that people who could only walk 2 miles an hour had most prediction of death at the end of the study within 5 years. But not one single person in the study died when they could walk at 3 miles an hour or above. So, and the translation I hope can say that the Grim Reaper, the person that comes and takes us away when we die, he cannot walk at 3 miles an hour. He can walk at 2.9 miles an hour, and therefore he can't catch you if you can walk at 3 miles an hour. So all we have to do is get the population of Italy to walk at 3 miles an hour, and nobody will ever die. It'll just go on forever. And this is a good paper if you have to read it. The British Medical Journal a couple of years ago, in 2011, and it was talking about the speed of the Grim Reaper.